Hi, I'm Greg. In this video, we're going to go over activity chaining, how to use it, and share some examples of when to use it in your process designs. Now, this video is brought to you by Appian Community, so be sure to check out our other great videos linked in the description below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment to see more videos like this one. All right, let's get started. Activity chaining is a capability of process models that allow users to define wizard-like behavior between any number of user activities, like user input tasks. Now imagine you are a developer for an organization that requires its users to complete multiple forms in succession. In a process model, this might look like two user input tasks directly next to each other. Without activity chaining, the second user input task would be treated as a task and would need to be accessed from a task list. Now, this does not provide the best user experience when they need to navigate somewhere else to continue their workflow. By enabling activity chaining between two user input task nodes, the user will immediately be shown the second user input task after clicking submit on the first. While you can achieve the same form-like behavior directly in the interface using SAIL, activity chaining in a process allows you to incorporate system activities that need to complete before showing the second user input task to the user. In these scenarios, the second user input task may evaluate differently based on the information gathered from the first user input task, or based on information gathered from those system activities. Just as activity chaining can be enabled between user input task nodes, it can also be enabled between a start form and user input task. The purpose and behavior would be the same, only difference is the first node would be the start node with a process start form configured on it. Activity chaining can also be used from the start node when starting a process from a record action, related action, or a bang start process link. Imagine a user who needs to trigger a process from a dashboard. Using the a bang start process link function on an interface, or a record action button and activity chaining in the linked process, a user can trigger a process directly on the dashboard and immediately be shown the start form or any initially chained forms. This can be helpful when specific, up-to-date information must be retrieved first before the user can complete the first form. Using activity chaining in your workflows can provide users with a smoother experience when a user needs to complete multiple forms in succession. Just keep in mind there is a 50-node limit for chaining. Check out some activity chaining patterns in Appian documentation linked in the description below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.